Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Overcoming Graduation with Brian Drury. For anyone who is new to the show, Overcoming Graduation is a podcast where I work to teach young adults everything I wished I'd known about life to help them graduate to the next level. So today, we're going to be talking about your music library. Now, if you think about the music that's in your library, like me, you probably have way more songs than you need. You have a ton of nonsense in there. You have songs you downloaded back when you were in middle school, maybe, or even younger, that you never listen to anymore. I have thousands of songs in my iTunes library, and all I can think about is how often I'm skipping and skipping and skipping, trying to find something that fits my mood or something that I still enjoy. And there's oftentimes where I'll see a song dozens of times and go, I need to get that out of my library, but I never do. Until finally, recently, I got started and I trimmed out 500 songs and I miss none of them. So another interesting thing is that there are times when I'll get very much caught up in the same songs and I'll just be listening to the same thing over and over again, and I'll never branch out into anything new. I won't go searching for new music. I won't try and check out something on YouTube, a recommended video, because I'm just like, no, this is good enough for now. So the reason I'm talking about the music library is what I realized is that is a very powerful analogy for life. How many of us have way more things going on, way more actual physical possessions than we actually need, and we spend so much time preoccupying about all the things that we don't want that we're saying yes to and all the things that we have that we don't really want or enjoy. We're spending so much time taking care of those things. We're spending so much time accommodating other people and working to people please, and we do all of this in the hopes that people will like us, that we'll be connected, that somehow we won't be alone. And then on the other hand, we're also afraid to try new things at many times because we found something that we feel comfortable with. We feel like we're at a level that makes sense to us and this is good enough and maybe this is the happiest that I can be with this type of song. So I'm just going to stick with this. I know this, it's comfortable, and it's familiar. So what ends up happening in life at anything when you stagnate and you just stay listening to the same songs? One, you can begin to devalue them. You start to just say, oh yeah, this is what I listen to all the time, and you don't remember that initial spark, that joy, that energy that it inspired in you, that different thought or feeling that it evoked in you just from the sounds coming through your earbuds or through your speakers. We also can block out the rest of the world. We can block out possibility. We can say, no, I know what I like, and this is it, and I have it. So I don't need any of that other stuff because I've already figured out everything that I like in my life. Now, here's the interesting thing I've learned through travel, through trying lots of new things, and through consistently pushing myself way out of my comfort zone, is that you often don't know, at least this is true for me, that's all I can speak to is what I know for myself, but often the things that we think we know and we have a firm grasp on how the world works, quote unquote, when we push ourselves outside our comfort zone, we introduce ourselves to new possibilities and new opportunities and new things that we didn't even know we liked or didn't even know existed. And all of a sudden, when we experience those new things, those new cultures, those new languages, those new foods, we start to have that amazingly powerful question of what else is out there? What else exists that I don't know about? What else could there be? How much stronger could these emotions be? How much more joy could I experience? What other flavors exist that would ignite me and turn me on in this way where I'm just so blown away that I can't even capture or say, explain what I'm trying to feel? It's something where when we get so wrapped up in our old habits and we get so locked on our possessions, both physical and mental, because we don't think about the mental space as something that gets clogged up with ideas and old beliefs. But when you think about all of the things that you're holding on to and you're worrying about and you're stressing about and how much value that really has, I can't tell you how many times I've caught myself stressing about just total, utter nonsense. I'm sitting there, I have so much in my life to be thankful for, I have so much to be grateful for, and I'm upset because I spilled a little mustard on my t-shirt that cost $8. Like, what in God's name is that to be upset about? So when we get so caught in our ways, we get so focused on creating what we think is control. And what control looks like is doing things the same way because we believe that there is safety in that, not just from a physical standpoint of being physically safe, but also from a mental and emotional standpoint. I know how things go when I do this. I know what it's like when I go there. I know what types of people will be there. I know who I'm going to go with and who I'm going to talk to. All of that gives us a sense of security that in many, many, many cases is just an illusion, because the belief that we're safe when we stay in our habits is not only wrong, just fundamentally wrong, but it is also dangerous, because that can be one of the biggest traps that keeps us from living our dreams and from making the unique impact we want in the world. Because we think, if I put myself out there, what if I'm not liked? So I'd rather stay in these habits. If I try to start that business and I fail, what if I can never get a job again? So I shouldn't even go for it. What if I go to dance class and I suck and everyone laughs at me and everyone thinks I'm weird and then I don't make friends and then I'm never accepted? Any of these things, guys, I firmly believe that it comes down to being loved and being accepted by others. Because, you know, why do you want that job and that prestige? Well, do you want money? Do you want fame? Do you want recognition? Even the money piece, I don't believe it's about money. I think it's about wanting to have a certain appearance. It's about wanting to be able to be free and do whatever you want. And another piece can be, if I could do all these things I wanted to, then people would like me. If I was more genuine expression of myself, then people would like me. Then that means that I need to get lots of money to have the things I want, to do the things I want, to meet the people I want, to be liked and to be loved, which is such a flawed assumption or a flawed flow of logic when you really get into it. So when we take this analogy of music and your music library, when was the last time you cleared it out? When was the last time you cleaned house? Because anyone who has done it, I just did a huge, huge clean out of my closet. And there's that emotional attachment to things and to clothes. And all of a sudden you think, oh, no, this was from freshman year. And this is when I went to Dayglow concert. And you didn't even remember it was there, but it was taking up space. And there was this piece of you that was constantly going, man, I need to clean out my closet. So when I got rid of all of it, donated so much of it to what was usable, to Goodwill, I'm like, this is sitting in my closet, not benefiting anyone. And this could be given to someone who would value this way more than I do. So why the hell am I holding on? And also it's taking up that mental space of, man, I really need to clean out my closet, which is always sitting there when you have one of those big to-dos. And then the actual physical space in my room, which is more stuff to manage, more stuff to take care of. It makes things easier to get lost. And when you're searching through your closet, you're like, why can't I find this? Because there's so much buried in there. So going through your music, your life's music library, clear out the things that don't have value for you. Clear out the things that you never want to listen to again. There's old thoughts and patterns and beliefs that you have in your life that don't serve you anymore, and they may have been from a past version of you. And they might even just be things that bring up painful memories. And it's like, why carry that with you? Why not let go? Why not just say you loved yourself in that moment, you love who you've grown into as a result of these challenges, and you're willing to let that go? And then what ends up happening when you're going through your music library, when you trim it from 4,000 down to 2,000 or something, you find that you're enjoying your music listening experience so much more because you've cleaned out the clutter and you've cleaned out the junk to a point where you have consolidated down and said no to other things and said yes to the things that you really love. So when it comes to opportunities and trying new things, there is music that you want to listen to. There's things that you want to try, but often we just say, no, I'm comfortable with what I got, or this is really all I listen to. I'm not even going to try that. When you take the time to experiment, to try, to see the dances associated, to see how dance is incorporated in culture through music, when you put all these pieces together and you compare this to your life, it is amazing what can come about. You open doors to new possibilities, new ways of thinking, and new ways of viewing the world. And if there's anything about your life that you don't feel serves you, do not accept it as your reality. Some people may say, well, you know, I have a physical disability. I have socioeconomic challenges. I have all of these various things, and the excuses are from some of the first things to pop up when people say, don't let your reality be unless it's something that just builds you up with so much love about life. So the reality is anybody can choose. Anyone can choose. Some people might say that's easy for me, having all of the advantages that I do in the world, and I would agree with them a lot, but there are also many challenges that have been thrown my way, and everyone faces different challenges. And when one of my mentors, Sean Stephenson, who was born with osteogenesis imperfecta and had 220 breaks and fractures in his body of his bones in the first 14 or 16 years of his life, and is now a speaker who shares the stage with the Dalai Lama, with Richard Branson, and who has traveled all over the world speaking and spreading a message, who's written best-selling books. If he can overcome that, if Lisa Nichols, who was a D and F student, who was told she was one of the worst writers one of her teachers had ever seen, was told she would be nothing, who had three or four fights every way to and from school because she lived in such a rough area, if she can be the first African-American woman to take her company public, these people are living examples. And if we only want to find examples of how shitty the world is, that's what we'll find. If you start to introduce yourself to other opportunities and other examples of how the world works and how it can be, and if you travel and see it for yourself instead of letting the news tell you that everything's falling apart, you will see that the world is filled with so much more good and so much more joy and so much more hope than we are led to believe. So start introducing yourself to new music and start introducing yourself to new realities, new possibilities, and new ways of thinking. If you are not happy with your playlist right now, start getting rid of the shit that doesn't serve you. Start chopping those things out. Start letting them go unapologetically. Start saying no to relationships that don't serve you and don't build you up or that are toxic in your life. Start saying hell yes and spending much more time with the songs that you love, the people, the experiences, the places, because you know in your heart what it is you want. You know what it is, what types of music in your heart that you love more than anything. And sometimes we'll want so badly to be accepted by the people around us that we will pretend to like other music, we will pretend to like other songs, and we will be living a lie and be completely out of integrity that whole time because we want so deeply and desperately to be accepted that we're willing to lie to ourselves and to the world the whole time, thinking that will make us happy, when on the inside there will always be this feeling of there is something more for me out there. So guys, when you are listening to this today, consider your life as this big musical playlist. What's the excess that you're carrying that you don't need? What is the stuff that picks you up, that fills you up? And I'm not just talking motivating positive songs. There's time where sad music can be so therapeutic. What are the songs that actually have value to you? Think about clearing out your closet and all of the things that don't have value and you just keep there, and whenever you pull them out, you go, oh no, that reminds me of like senior prom, but you really don't care. It's not the feelings that you want to re-experience. It's just like, oh no, it's hard to let go. Be willing to let go of who you were to become who you know you're meant to be. That is one of the most powerful quotes that I've heard. You have to be willing to let go of who you were at the drop of a hat to become who you know you're meant to be and who you really are. So be willing. It's scary. There's fear there. That what if I'm not accepted? What if I'm not loved? How about this? What if you find people that you connect with more than you ever had? What if you find the deepest love you've ever experienced? What if you find the place you've always wanted to live? What if you find the best song you've ever heard and it just keeps getting better every time you listen to it because you were willing to clear out all the other junk, you were willing to go explore, and you were willing to allow yourself the space to find all this music that really ignites your soul? Different music hits you at different times. The same song has a different meaning to you at different stages in your life. So why not focus on the best songs and the best messages to really fuel you and drive you? So thank you guys for listening today. This was one that hit me, and the analogy and the metaphor was something I wrote down on a sticky note earlier today at work, and I was like, this is something I really want to talk about because I think metaphors are so powerful when it comes to stories and communicating messages. And Sean Stephenson, in fact, said, if you can talk in metaphors, you can explain brain surgery to a 3-year-old. So this is something where I'm working to enhance and build that ability in my life so I can better communicate with everyone I meet. So thank you guys all for listening today. As always, if this was of value to you, it would be a huge honor if you would share it with your friends and following. I love to see comments and questions and feedback, so please feel free to reach out to me at brian@overcominggraduation.com. If you'd like to learn more about the OCG community and what I am working to do through Overcoming Graduation, you can check out and subscribe to the Overcoming Graduation podcast on iTunes and Stitcher. You can go to overcominggraduation.com. Or you can check out Overcoming Graduation on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. And if you would like to access your free book bonuses from my number one Amazon best-selling book, The First Step, you can visit thefirststepgift.com to get the Dream Job Passion Finder questionnaire, the Rapid Language Learning Starter Kit teaching you how to learn a new Latin-based language in 3 months, and the Overcoming Graduation interview bundle for free. Just enter your name and email, and you'll get those free things emailed to you, or you can click on the buttons and download them right there on the page. So, guys, thank you so much for joining me today. It has been a pleasure and an honor sharing this time with you, and I hope to be talking to you guys again real soon.